Hello, hi everybody. I am Thekla Petridou, a psychologist, YouTuber obviously, and author. And this is our weekly video in English. It's Friday, the 19th of February 2021. And today's topic is basic. A basic topic in psychology and psychotherapy. Building resilience in a chaotic world. Resilience is a basic term in psychology and psychotherapy. I chose to read for you from the basic terms of psychology today. I will include the link in the description of the video. What us psychologists mean when we use the word resilience. Resilience is the psychological quality that allows some people to be knocked down by the adversities of life and come back at least as strong as before. Some people are resilient, some people are highly resilient, and some people are non-resilient. Resilient people, rather than letting difficulties, traumatic events, or failure overcome them and drain their resolve, they find a way to change course, emotionally heal, and continue moving towards their goals. The term of resilience and the actual psychological virtue of resilience is about this. Something bad happens to you, your plans do not go as you wished, you had a traumatic event, you have a failure, you have a bad change of plans, but you do not allow yourself to be beaten down by the adversities, but you find a way to come back at least as strong as you were before. Some people are even able to come back from adversities being stronger than before. What creates resilience? Psychologists have identified some of the factors that appear to make a person more resilient, such as positive attitude. Having a positive attitude means that you are an optimist. Optimism. The ability to regulate emotions and the ability to see failure as a form of helpful feedback. Having a positive attitude, it's not something that you can order yourself to do. Please, relax. Please, stop being anxious about this issue. Please, stop obsessing about this. You should be relaxed. You should be optimistic about it. You should have a positive attitude. You cannot dictate to anybody, even yourself, to have a positive attitude. Positive attitude stems through optimism. And optimism, which is a positive stance in life, has been shown to help blunt the impact of stress on the mind and body in the wake of disturbing experiences. That gives people access to their own cognitive resources, enabling cool-headed analysis of what might have gone wrong and consideration of behavioral paths that might be more productive. When we have a negative event in our life, a failure, a traumatic event, we get overwhelmed by stress and negative emotions, and we become unable to use our own cognitive and emotional resources in order to solve the problem or find a way to get away from it or even benefit from it. Every person we all have emotional and cognitive reserves. We are built, our body and organism is, and the brain is built in that way so that we can survive adversities. Even though we are born in the modern era, we have primitive bodies and primitive brains that give us the resources to overcome difficulties. In order to access these resources, you need to be cool-headed. You need to be not stressed. And optimism as a stance of life, if you choose to look at life from an optimistic point of view, allows you to cool down stress and be able to use your brain in order to overcome difficulties. We all have brains. We all have cognitive and emotional resources. Our body is built in that way so that when, let's say that we're like a car that runs on petrol, when our petrol finishes, there is a small reserve that it is actually beneficial in order to overcome the difficulty and find the time to go and fill our car with petrol again. But in order to be able to go to that reserve, to that cognitive and emotional reserve, you need to remain cool. And optimism helps you remain cool. Of course, there are other aspects of resilience roots that remain under study. It's a very new concept in psychology, resilience, and it has been invented and used by positive psychologists, which positive psychology is a stream in psychology that started around the new millennial. In around 2000, positive psychology has started to be formed as a new psychological, theoretical paradigm and psychotherapeutic paradigm. So we have a lot to study about resilience, but it seems that some people are born with genetic predisposition for resilience. I know such people. One of those people is my father. My father, who is 26 years older than me, so he's 71, he will be 72 this June. He's a highly resilient person. He has been through many adversities in life. But what I have watched over the years, over the 45 years that I know him, is that he is able to cool quickly when he gets upset, when he gets sad, when he gets overwhelmed by adversities of life that happen to everybody, not just to my father or me or you. Everybody has adversities in life. When something bad happens, he takes the time to cool off, cool down, and then use his brain in order to make the most out of it. And this has helped him to overcome difficulties. And also, I think that he also has, he doesn't have a genetic predisposition for depression and anxiety, whereas other members of our family, we have genetic predisposition to depression and anxiety. So people who are who incline to get stressed and depressed when they have a trauma, when they have a traumatic experience, when they experience a failure, it's very easy to go into depression, shut down, and seeing nothing positive in the whole experience. And even storming out their negative emotions on themselves or other people around them. Can resilience be taught? Yes. Resilience can be taught. Many factors that determine resilience, such as genetics, early life experiences, and luck, can't be modified. You cannot change your genes. You cannot change what happened already in your life and what your experience has, but what your experience were till now. But specific resilience building skills can be learned. These include breaking out of negative thought cycles, cognitive therapy. Ellis, for example, he was Albert Ellis was very well renowned about him identifying negative thought cycles or negative thought patterns, and due his therapeutic approach, he taught people on how to break these patterns. Can be very helpful in order to build resilience. You identify that you have negative thoughts, that these negative thoughts, they come as circles and they make you even more depressed, even more worn down, even in a worse psychological condition. And identifying those negative thought patterns and breaking them can help you to build resilience. Also, if you understand and you realize that you have a tendency to catastrophize, that everything, anything that happens, you see it from a positive, a negative point of view, and you think of the worst, you might learn to push yourself back from catastrophizing and looking for upsides when faced with setbacks. And this is a technique that can be taught. you learn that every time something negative happens in our lives, there is always a positive outcome out of it. I'm Greek, Greek Cypriot, and we have a lot of proverbs in my language about, in Greek language, about this thing. I will tell you now in Greek Cypriot dialect one proverb which says, "O Theos kli porte chaniga maroportes," which means God allows for some doors to close for you, but He also opens huge doors for you, which means that every adversity that happens in your life, even though it wears you down, even though it makes you sad, even though it makes you upset and overwhelmed, have faith in God that this adversity will give you a new opportunity for post-traumatic growth. What is post-traumatic growth? After experiencing trauma, many people find deeper psychological and spiritual meaning in their lives. Known as post-traumatic growth, these are the survivors. These are the people who manage to survive from adversities in their life and use those adversities for their own benefit, finding deeper psychological and spiritual meaning. It doesn't always occur immediately after the trauma, and the individual may still experience symptoms of anxiety, depressions, or flashbacks. This very basic article of psychologytoday.com, as I said earlier, I will include in the description of this video so that you can read it yourselves. Post-traumatic growth is a phenomenon that it's a phenomenal phenomenon that is usually so breathtaking that us therapists get amazed by how people can grow spiritually and psychologically and emotionally after negative events in their lives. And when it happens, it shows that this person has become more mature psycho-emotionally and socially and spiritually. And even if you experience a traumatic event in your life, a setback or a failure, and you feel stressed and you feel depressed and you have the symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder, you can still benefit from this period of your life, from this not so good period in your life. You can still benefit from it and try to reach post-traumatic growth. The ways to do that are simple. First of all, therapy. You need to attend to your traumas. Psychotherapy. If you have symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder, such as depression, anxiety, night terrors, disrupted sleep, you might need to see a psychiatrist and get a prescription for antidepressants for as long as your doctor advises you to. We never stop our antidepressant medication by ourselves. We do so only with the advice of our psychiatrist, but the combined method of psychotherapy plus antidepressant medication can help you get relief from your symptoms and help you to be able to learn through psychotherapy and through personal and spiritual battle how to grow emotionally, psychologically, and spiritually after a traumatic event. So resilience could be also be described as post-traumatic growth, or the basic tool to lead you to post-traumatic growth. How do we build resilience in a chaotic world? Today's world is chaotic, and I think it has always been. The world has always been chaotic, not just today. But we know about our own problems and our own chaos, chaotic situations. In this chaotic world, if you decide that you will benefit from the adversities and you will teach yourself how to be resilient, either by watching psychoeducational videos or by reading psychology books and philosophy books and self-help books, or by attending therapy or attending lectures on these issues or attending group therapy, you will find your way to build resilience and become a highly resilient person that enjoys life, and even when life is bitter and gives you lemonades, you are able to make the sweetest lemonade out of them. I wish to all of us to have resilience and be able to cope with the adversities in life. Have a lovely weekend, everybody. See you next Friday with a new video in English. Bye!